By now, it's safe to say that anyone still using a Windows version older than 10 is either not interested in the newer version, or they can't run it for some reason or another. But what if somehow you didn't get the automatic upgrade in 2016? You've been holding on all these years, and you want to upgrade now? After all, better late than never. You don't have to upgrade, but you can still do it if you want to. For example, my main PC has Windows 10, but I still use Windows 7 and XP on other computers sometimes. This is a test PC on which I restored the original software it would have come with when it was new in 2010. It's Windows 7 with all the original Lenovo applications. To make it look less like a brand new installation, I also installed a few extra programs and created a test document using the included version of Word. We'll see if they stick through with the upgrade. And so now I want to upgrade. How do you do that? Well, it's simple. All you need is an activated copy of Windows, which we have, and the Windows Media Creation tool. Despite its name, it can also be used to upgrade a PC without creating installation media. Remember to back up all your important stuff. The upgrade takes a while, so of course the video is sped up. Speaking of computers taking a while to do things, sometimes software upgrades aren't enough. You may also need some hardware upgrades. Windows 10 can be more demanding on some older systems, which is another reason why some people didn't upgrade. You could buy a brand new computer, but for a much lower price and a small amount of labor, you can replace the hard drive with a solid state drive. You've probably heard this already, but it still needs to be said. It really does make a big difference, even if you decide to stick with Windows 7. Mechanical hard drives should only be used for additional storage or for operating systems older than Windows 7. Anyway, we hit a little stumbling block. Unfortunately, we have to say goodbye to Office 2010 Starter, which only has Word and Excel. Or is Click to Run just a launcher to sell the full version and the actual programs will remain? We'll find out later. So, ready to install Windows 10 Pro, keeping personal files and apps? Let's go! And there it is. It removed several more apps. ThinkManage fingerprint software. No big deal, you can set up your fingerprint using Windows Hello in the Settings app. Bing Bar, no comment. Create Recovery Media, well, it's a different OS, so you should expect that it doesn't work anymore. ThinkPad Bluetooth with enhanced data rate software. You can just use the regular Bluetooth settings in Windows. But the rest of the programs still seem to be there. ThinkManage toolbox still works. And now my camera has started falling off the tripod, but sadly it was the other way around. Word and Excel were uninstalled, but the Office 2010 Starter launcher remained. Shame. We can still open this test document with WordPad, but it's not quite the same, obviously. Also, the weather in the taskbar glitched up. Not to mention the wrong temperature unit. I mean, it is set to English US, but if it can detect my location, it should also be able to set the correct temperature unit for it. Maybe it assumes that I'm traveling. So how does the upgraded OS run? Thanks to the SSD, it runs fine. With a slower hard drive, it will still run fine, but it would be really slow. Then again, Windows 7 will be quite slow as well, so it wouldn't be a huge slowdown. Right after the upgrade, it might be a little too slow, but just give it a few minutes and it should settle. A new installation would run better than an upgraded one. In fact, that's what this computer runs normally. I just backed it up and wiped the hard drive and installed Windows 7 to try this upgrade. The upgrade is still a good option if you're too lazy to set up everything again after a clean installation. Despite Windows 11 being out, Windows 7 is safe to use until October 2025. But even after that date comes, it will be the same deal as any other OS losing support, where you can still use it with no problem, even though there are no more security updates for it, just like Windows 7 right now. It's best to keep your computer up to date, but as long as you're aware of what you're doing, what you do on your own computer is up to you. Thank you for watching.